IIET NCERT presents audiobook
Introductory Microeconomics. Page 9. 1. Theory of Consumer Behavior.
Module 1.1. Budget Line. Rationale. Budget line of a consumer helps to understand the most important concept of scarcity, possibility set, and opportunity cost. Key concepts: budget, budget line, budget set, slope of budget line, opportunity cost.
1.1.1. Drawing a budget line. No individual has the income to buy everything in the world for himself or herself. Since our income, or say, our budget is limited, there is a constraint on what we can afford to buy from the market. With a fixed income, we cannot buy more of any one good without buying less of some other good. Therefore, it is important for us to understand the budget constraints and the exchange between commodities we buy because of the constraint. Let us begin with the introduction to one basic tool of our analysis, and that is a two-dimensional graph. We consume many goods, but since we only have two axes in a two-dimensional graph, we will assume, for simplification, that we consume only two goods. Figure 1.1, budget line. Here we have a graph with two axes. X-axis represents the amount of pencils bought or consumed. The Y-axis represents the amount of bananas bought or consumed. The X-axis has been divided into 10 equal parts. The Y-axis has also been divided into 10 equal parts. Here, we have a downward sloping line AB, which represents the different sets of consumption of banana and pencil. Point A represents 5,0, which means 5 pencils and 0 bananas have been bought. Point C represents 4,2, which means 4 pencils and 2 bananas have been bought. Point Q represents 2,3, which means 2 pencils and 3 bananas have been bought. Note that point Q is not on the downward sloping line AB. Point D represents 3,4, which means 3 pencils and 4 bananas have been bought. Point B represents 0,10, which means 0 pencils and 10 bananas have been bought. Let us assume that the two goods consumed are pencils and bananas. In figure 1.1, we place the quantity of pencils on the horizontal, that is x-axis, and the quantity of bananas on the vertical, that is y-axis. Page 10. Since any good is available in positive quantities only, we choose to work in the positive or first quadrant of the two-dimensional graph. Let us consider a consumer who gets rupees 10 of income to spend on pencils and bananas. Let us further assume that the price of one pencil and one banana in the market is rupees 2 and rupee 1 respectively. Now, suppose the consumer decides to spend all her income only on pencils. Then, what is the maximum number of pencils she can buy? The answer is 5, since the income available is rupees 10 and the price of a pencil is rupees 2. We mark this maximum quantity purchasable of pencil as point A in our figure 1.1. Point A happens to lie on the horizontal axis. This is because when the consumer is spending all her income on pencils, then she cannot buy any bananas. As an ordered pair of numbers, point A is expressed as 5,0, that is, a bundle having 5 pencils and no bananas. On the other hand, if the consumer spends all her income on bananas, then she will be able to buy 10 bananas. As shown in figure 1.1, we mark this maximum quantity purchasable of bananas as point B on the vertical axis. As an ordered pair of numbers, point B is expressed as 0,10, that is, a bundle having no pencils and 10 bananas. From now on, we would use the terms bundles and combinations interchangeably. We know that the bundles A and B cost exactly equal to the budget of the consumer. If we join points A, which is 5,0, and B, which is 0,10 in figure 1.1, using a straight line, then we get the line segment AB. This line segment AB is known as the budget line of a consumer. We claim that this line AB passes through all bundles of pencils and bananas which cost exactly equal to the consumer's budget of Rs. 10. How can we say that? Suppose, instead of buying 5 pencils as in bundle A, the consumer buys only 4 pencils. Given that the price of pencil is Rs. 2 per unit, she spends only Rs. 8 of her income. Thus, she has not yet exhausted all her budget and is still left with Rs. 2, which she can use to buy bananas. She can buy 2 bananas with the remaining income, since the price per banana is Rs. 1. This new bundle with 4 pencils and 2 bananas costs exactly equal to the consumer's budget of Rs. 10, just like the bundles A and B. Bundle 4,2 is represented in the figure 1.1 as point C on the budget line AB. If what we said earlier, that is, all bundles costing Rs. 10 are on line AB, is true, then C must also lie on line AB. For this to happen, the slope of line segment AB must be equal to the slope of the line segment AC. If the slopes are different, then surely point C cannot lie on the line segment AB. But what is the slope of the budget line AB?
Page 11. 1.1.2. Slope of a budget line. We know that the slope of any straight line is defined as the change in value of a variable represented on the y-axis, that is, the rise or delta y, divided by the change in value of variable represented on the x-axis, that is, the run or delta x. Thus, the slope of the budget line AB is given by delta y divided by delta x, where delta y represents change in quantity of bananas and delta x represents change in quantity of pencils. As we move between any two points along the budget line. In figure 1.1, as you move from B to A along the budget line, delta y is equal to minus 10. And delta x is equal to plus 5. Therefore, the slope of budget line is given by minus 10 divided by 5, which is equal to minus 2. As you move along the budget line from point B to A, that is, from up to down, then quantity of pencils increases. This implies a positive change in quantity of pencils. At the same time, the quantity of bananas decreases, implying a negative change in the quantity of bananas. Now, if you choose to move from point A to B, that is, from down to up along the budget line, then quantity of pencils decreases, implying a negative change in quantity of pencils. Along with this, the quantity of bananas increases, implying a positive change in the quantity of bananas. Thus, the change in quantities of the two goods is always in the opposite direction along the budget line. This implies the budget line slopes downwards and has a negative value. Another question is whether the slope of AB is the same as the slope of AC. Slope of AC would be given by the change in quantity of good 2 divided by the change in quantity of good 1 as we move from point A to C or vice versa. In figure 1.1, as we move from point A to C, delta x is equal to minus 1, while delta y is equal to plus 2. Therefore, the slope of AC is also minus 2. This implies that C also lies on the budget line. Hence, combination of goods indicated on budget line means that all the income has been spent. Further, as the consumer moves from point C to D, she increases the purchase of bananas by reducing the purchase of pencils. In other words, the decrease in expenditure on pencils is always equal in magnitude to increase in expenditure on bananas. We know that the increase in the slope of budget line can be interpreted as decreased purchase of 2 bananas when she decides to buy 1 more pencil and vice versa. Buying 1 more of a pencil requires rupees 2, and this rupees 2 is equivalent to 2 bananas since each banana costs rupee 1. Thus, we can say that the gain of 1 more pencil is at the cost of 2 bananas. The absolute value of the slope of the budget line is known as the opportunity cost of pencil, which is our good 1, in terms of bananas, which is our good 2. It is equal to the price per unit of pencil P1 divided by the price per unit of banana P2. It can be written as P1 divided by P2, which is also the slope of the budget line. This is also known as the relative price of good 1 pencil to good 2 banana. Let us generalize the pencil and banana example to any good 1 and good 2. As depicted in figure 1.2, quantity of good 1 is placed on the horizontal axis and quantity of good 2 is placed on the vertical axis. Let the income of the consumer be denoted by capital M and price per unit of good 1 be denoted by P1. And the price per unit of good 2 be denoted by P2. Also assume that all the prices and incomes are expressed in rupees. Page 12. Figure 1.2. Budget line of a consumer. Here we have a graph in which good 1 is represented on the horizontal axis. Good 2 is represented on the vertical axis. Both good 1 and good 2 have 8 parts in all. There is a downward sloping line AB, represented by P1X1 plus P2X2 equal to capital M. Our starting point A is represented by M by P1, 0. We have another point C, which shows that 5 parts of good 1 and 3 parts of good 2 have been consumed. At point D, we find that only 4 parts of good 1 and 4 parts of good 2 have been consumed. At point B, which is represented by 0, m by P2, we find that 8 parts of good 2 have been consumed and 0 parts of good 1 have been consumed. If the consumer buys x1 units of good 1 and x2 units of good 2, then the total expenditure needed is P1X1 plus plus P2X2. If we join all those bundles, X1, X2, which cost exactly equal to the budget M of the consumer, then we get a line called the budget line. Therefore, the points on the budget line consist of all the combinations of two commodities which cost exactly equal to the income M of the consumer. Mathematically, it is given by the equality P1X1 plus P2X2 is equal to M. Note that LHS, left-hand side of this equality, is the total expenditure of the consumer. But how do we show this budget line geometrically in a two-dimensional graph? We know that the consumer can buy maximum of M by P1 of good 1 if she spends all her budget on good 1. In the figure 1.2, the combination having M by P1 of good 1 and no amount of good 2 is depicted as point A. Similarly, she can buy maximum of M by P2 of good 2 if she spends all her budget on good 2. The combination having none of good 1 and M by P2 of good 2 is represented by point B. In the above analysis, we saw that the budget line is a combination of goods that cost exactly equal to the budget of a consumer. For a consumer with budget M and spending on goods with prices P1 and P2 respectively, budget line is mathematically represented by the equation P1X1 plus P2X2 is equal to M. This line has y-intercept of M by P2 and the x-intercept of M by P1. The slope of this line is given by delta x2 by delta x1 is equal to minus P1 by P2. The slope of this line is given by delta x2 divided by delta x1 equal to minus P1 by P2.
1.1.3 Budget set. If the income is M, the consumer cannot spend more than M. She can buy only those combinations, that is X1, X2, for which P1X1 plus P2X2 is less than or equal to M. This inequality represents the budget constraint. Page 13. It is satisfied by all bundles which the consumer could afford to buy, spending her income M either fully or partly. The set of all such affordable bundles is known as the budget set of the consumer. This set has bundles which cost equal to or less than the income. Figure 1.3 Budget set. Here we have a graph with two axes, X and Y. The X axis represents good 1. The Y axis represents good 2. On the graph, we have a downward sloping line AB. There are points F and G which represent different bundles of good 1 and good 2 which a consumer can consume. Point E represents a point inside the budget line. This means that the person is spending less than his income. There is also a point here which is point H. This point is outside the budget line. This means that the bundle H requires the person to spend more than his income. Follow the figure 1.3. Budget set is represented by all the bundles which are lying in the triangular region OAB. It includes the bundles on the line segment AB, which moves from low to up along the budget line. OA which is on the horizontal axis or x-axis, and OB, which is on the vertical y-axis. Note that AB is nothing but budget line of the consumer. Any point in this region other than the line segment AB, as indicated by point E, costs less than the income M of the consumer. If it costs equal to M, then it would be on the budget line AB. And if it costs more, as indicated by point H, then it would not satisfy the budget constraint P1X1 plus P2X2 should be less than equal to M. In this case, the equation will be P1X1 plus P2X2 is greater than M. We can prove mathematically that points below the budget line cost less than consumer's income. In figure 1.3, take any point E below the budget line. From this point E, move in horizontal direction to point F, or in the vertical direction to point G on the budget line. It is clear that compared to point E, F has more of good 1 with the same amount of good 2, and G has more of good 2 with the same amount of good 1. Since bundles F and G are on the budget line, they cost exactly equal to the consumer's income, M. Therefore, since E has less of at least one good compared to F and G, so it must cost less than M.
Page 14. 1.1.4 Changes in the budget set. In the following section, we will consider the two ways in which the budget set can change. The first way is a parallel shift in position of the budget line, and the second way is the pivotal, that is, rotational shift about one of the intercepts of the budget line. Effect of change in income on budget line. Again, let the income of a consumer be M, and market price of the two goods be P1 and P2. Thus, M by P1 and M by P2 is respectively the X and Y axis intercepts of the budget line. Suppose income of the consumer increases and the new income is M dash, while prices of the two goods remain unchanged. Since prices are unchanged, so P1 by P2 will also remain unchanged. This implies that slope of the budget line given by P1 by P2 will also remain unchanged. But since the income has increased while prices are unchanged, the consumer can now buy more of both goods. Figure 1.4a depicts the increased affordability through a parallel and rightward shift in the budget line. This new budget line is marked as A-B- in the figure, and it has greater intercepts equal to M dash by P1 on the x-axis and M dash by P2 on the y-axis. The shift is parallel because the slope of new budget line is equal to the slope of old budget line. Note that both the x and y intercepts are changing here, while the slope of the budget line remains unchanged. This can only happen when both intercepts increase by the same percentage or proportion. Figure 1.4a. Rightward and parallel shift of budget line due to increase in income. Here, on the x-axis is good 1 and on the y-axis is good 2. We can find out here that there are two lines, AB and A'B'. Point A is represented by M by P1 and point B is represented by M by P2. And these two points are joined by line AB. Similarly, point A' is represented by M dash by P1 and point B dash is represented by M dash by P2. These two points are joined by the line A dash B dash. The arrow indicates the shift from point AB to new point A dash B dash. The new budget set represented by the region OA dash B dash is clearly wider than the region OAB. We can also say that the new budget set now has more combination of goods than before. Page 15. Likewise, we could consider the case of a decrease in income to a level M dash dash, while prices remain unchanged. Since the slope has remained unchanged, as also depicted by figure 1.4b, there is a parallel and a leftward shift in the budget line, because the consumer can now buy less of both goods. The new budget line is marked as A dash dash B dash dash. It has smaller intercepts equal to M dash dash by P1 on the x-axis and M dash dash by P2 on the y-axis. The decrease in affordable opportunities of consumption is also clear through narrowing of the region below the budget line. Figure 1.4b. Leftward and parallel shift of budget line due to decrease in income. Here, good 1 is shown on the x-axis. Good 2 is shown on the y-axis. There are two downward sloping lines, AB and A dash dash B dash dash. Point A on the x-axis is represented by M by P1. And point B on the y-axis is represented by M by P2. Point A dash dash on the x-axis is represented by M dash dash by P1. And point B dash dash is represented on the y-axis as M dash dash by P2. The left side arrow indicates that line AB shifts to new budget line A dash dash B dash dash. The new budget set represented by the region below the new budget line OA dash dash B dash dash is clearly inside the area OAB. We can also say that the new budget set now has fewer combinations of goods than before.
1.1.6 Effect of change in price on budget line. Now, let us consider one other possible way in which the budget set could change. Think what would happen to the budget line and the budget set if the income of the consumer and price of one good remains unchanged while only the price of the other good changes. As usual, we assume that the income is M and the initial prices are P1 and P2. Suppose the income and price of good 2 remains unchanged at M and P2 respectively, while the price of good 1 increases to P1 dash. The maximum amount purchasable of good 2, that is the y-intercept of the budget line, would remain fixed at M by P2. On the other hand, the x-intercept decreases to M by P1 dash. In the figure 1.5a, the new budget line is marked as A dash B, which we get by pivoting or rotating old budget line leftwards in the clockwise direction around the unchanged y-intercept. Page 16. Since the price of good 1 has changed, while the price of good 2 is constant, the slope of the budget line increases to P1 dash by P2. The new budget line is steeper than the old one. Figure 1.5a, change in budget line due to increase in price of good 1. Here, we have a graph with two axes, x and y. X-axis represents good 1. Y-axis represents good 2. We have a downward sloping budget line AB. A is represented on x-axis by the point M by P1, and B is represented on the y-axis by M by P2. Due to an increase in price, the budget line shifts to A dash by B. The new point A dash is represented by M by P dash, and B is represented by M by P2. In figure 1.5a, the new budget set is represented by the area below the new budget line OA dash B dash is clearly inside the area OAB. We can also say that the new budget set now has fewer combinations of goods than before. Figure 1.5b. Change in budget line due to decrease in price of good 1. Here, we have a graph with two axes, x and y. X-axis represents good 1 and y-axis represents good 2. The initial budget line AB shifts to the new budget line A-B. The point A is represented on the x-axis by M by P1 and A-dash is represented on the x-axis by M by P1 dash. The point B is represented on the y-axis by M by P2. There is an arrow here which is pointing in the right direction. This arrow is between the line AB and A-B. This signifies a movement in the budget line due to decrease in price of good 1. In figure 1.5b, the effect of decrease in price of good 1 is demonstrated. Let the new price of good 1 be again denoted by P1 dash. This time, the budget line will pivot or rotate rightwards or in anti-clockwise direction around the y-intercept. The x-intercept has now become larger and the new budget line A-B is flatter, which is to say the new slope of P1 dash by P2 is less than before. The new budget set is represented in figure 1.5b by the area OA-B, which is wider than the old budget set represented by the region OAB. More combinations of goods have become affordable due to a decrease in the price of at least one good, while income and price of other good remains unchanged. Page 17. A similar analysis could be done by changing the price of good 2 instead of price of good 1. In this case, the budget line would pivot about the unchanged x-intercept and, as depicted in figure 1.6a, it will rotate anti-clockwise when the price of good 2 rises. As evident in figure 1.6b, the budget line will rotate clockwise when the price of good 2 falls. Figure 1.6a, change in budget line, increase in price of good 2. Here we have a graph with two axes, x and y. X-axis represents good 1, y-axis represents good 2. The initial budget line is represented by AB. The budget line moves to AB dash due to a change in price of good 2. This is represented by a downward arrow which is between the line AB and AB dash. The point A is at the x-axis and is represented by M by P1. The point B is at the y-axis and is represented by M by P2. The point B dash is also at the y-axis and is represented by M by P dash 2. Figure 1.6b. Change in budget line due to decrease in price of good 2. Here we have a graph with two axes, X and Y. On X axis we have good 1 and on Y axis we have good 2. The initial budget line AB moves to AB dash due to a change in price of good 2. This is represented by an arrow in the upward direction, which is between AB and AB dash. The point A is represented on X axis by M by P1. The point B is represented on the Y axis by M by P2. The point B dash is represented on the Y axis by M by P dash 2. Therefore, keeping income and price of one good unchanged, fall in the price of other good widens the budget set, while the rise in its price narrows the budget set.
You were just listening to this chapter. Subject Coordinator, Dr. Jaya Singh. Production Assistant, Jagbandhu Jana. Sound Recordist, Batilang Lindo and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And presented by CIET, NCERT, New Delhi, India.